There's no doubt MrBeast is one of the leading YouTubers and an inspiration for other creators. One of his secrets for attracting viewers is through his iconic thumbnails, which he reports spending around $10,000 per thumbnail. His thumbnails are characterized by smooth airbrush portraits and bold, lavish backgrounds. And so today, I'm going to show you how to turn your photos from this to this using Adobe Photoshop Beta. And by the end of this video, you'll be producing thumbnails as good as MrBeast. So I'm going to be working with this image today from Big Stock. And one of the reasons MrBeast thumbnails are so effective are because they convey a sense of emotion, and in this case, a sense of excitement. And so that's why I picked this image. Since it's a stock image, it isn't bad quality, but if we zoom in here, you can see a few blemishes, and it doesn't have the smoothness of a MrBeast photo. So to do this, we're going to select our quick mask down here, or use the shortcut key Q, and we're going to double click our foreground color and set the brightness to 30. Hit OK, and then use the shortcut Alt-Delete to fill your layer, or alternatively, go up to Edit and down to Fill. Make sure your contents are set to foreground color and hit OK. Now we can exit our quick mask by hitting Q again. And in our generative fill bar, we're going to type in the prompt skin retouching, skin smoothing, and skin lightening, and then hit generate. It's going to give you three variations that you can choose from. These might be quite terrifying to look at, but don't worry too much. We're just looking for one to best match our image and has the best skin contour. I'm not quite happy with these three, so to generate three more variations, we're just going to hit generate again. And it's going to give us three more. So this one's looking pretty good. You can see it's got nice smooth skin that we can work with. So once you're happy, we're going to jump back into our layers panel, and we're just going to mask out a few of these key areas. So that being the eyes, the ears, the mouth and teeth, and some of these edges, as well as we're going to mask out the hoodie. And so select your mask layer and choose the paintbrush tool. Make sure it's set to black. And we're just going to zoom in here. We're just going to paint over our image. Once you're happy with your mask layer selected, we're going to go up to Image and Apply Image. As you can see, it's going to start to merge those two layers. So I've got these settings selected, and then I'm going to hit OK. As you can see, it's done a pretty good job of airbrushing our image. The skin's looking nice and smooth, and some of those blemishes are now gone. So as you can see, his teeth are still looking a little bit yellow. So here's a quick tip to fix that. So let's jump across to Adjustments, and we're going to select Hue and Saturation. And we're going to click this drop down here by Master, and we're going to change it to yellow. Now we want to reduce our saturation down and bump our lightness up to around 30 here. And then in our layers, we're going to mask out our whole adjustment layer by having black selected and using the shortcut Alt-Delete to fill the layer. We're going to zoom in here, and with the paintbrush tool set to white, we're just going to paint back in our adjustment layer across our teeth. And as you can see, it's just going to remove our yellow tones from our teeth, making them look nice and white. You can also do it to the eyes if you think there's a little bit of yellow around there, and this is going to help whiten them up. If you want the final look to be a little bit more subtle, we can adjust the opacity of our fill layer. We're going to make one final adjustment to give our image a pop of color. And so bright colors like oranges are going to make your thumbnails stand out. So let's give him an orange hoodie. So to do this, let's select our layers, right click, and convert them to a smart object. We're now going to select our rectangle marquee tool and just draw it over your hoodie. And then all we have to do is type in orange hoodie and hit generate. And again, it's going to give us three options to choose from. So I quite like the look of this one. But as you can see, since we selected a bit of the face, it has made some changes to it. So we're just going to jump into our layers, select your hoodie mask, and then again with the paintbrush tool, set to black to remove, we're just going to paint over our face here. And there we have it. Here's a before and after of our image. Stay tuned for part two as we create the background using generative fill, and I'll show you some final tricks to finish off your thumbnail. Thanks for watching. If you want to be the first to hear about new and trending design tips, hit the subscribe button now and leave me a comment of any tutorials you want to see next. We'll see you next time.